Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. You awaken in the middle of the night with painful tingling sensations in your fingers, or maybe you're trying to apply lipstick or just pick up a pencil and it just falls from your grip. You might have carpal tunnel syndrome. Joining us to talk about this is Dr. Lorenzo Pacelli. He's an orthopedic surgeon with the Scripps Clinic Medical Group in La Jolla, California. He specializes in orthopedic surgery of the hand and the elbow. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you, Susan.
So what exactly is carpal tunnel syndrome?
So carpal tunnel syndrome is a very common problem we see in our orthopedic clinic. It's compression or pressure on a nerve that passes through the wrist area on the palm side of the hand and causes numbness and tingling in the thumb, index, middle finger, and sometimes half of the ring finger. And many times patients come in complaining of unable to sleep at night. They wake up in the middle of the night with their fingers and their hand going numb, dropping things like you described. Most of the time it's very debilitating because they can't sleep. That's the primary reason they come in.
So what causes this nerve to become compressed?
The carpal tunnel, as I said, is a small space that's in the center of the wrist. And this model kind of shows what's going on under the skin in your wrist. And in this space is one nerve and all the little tendons that go to the fingers. And all these little tendons are these white things here. Carpal tunnel is basically swelling in these tendons in a very tight space. And when the swelling gets to a certain point, the nerve gets compressed and squeezed, and then all those symptoms occur. So many things can cause that nerve to be compressed. Primarily, it's swelling in the tendons that go into the hand, and many different things, including pregnancy, overuse activities, excessive use of the hand, strenuous activities. Some diseases can also cause or predispose you to swelling in the flexor tendons, including diabetes and thyroid issues. But primarily activity use causes swelling in those flexor tendons.
So repetitive use of the wrists?
Exactly, repetitive use, overuse as well.
Would that be tennis, too much time on the computer?
Tennis, too much time on the computer, too much gardening, sometimes also too much cooking, cleaning around the house. Many times it's patients are predisposed to swelling and then they do those activities and then it presents as excessive swelling in those flexor tendons.
So who is most at risk?
You know, pregnant women, obviously, patients with some underlying diseases are at the greatest risk, diabetes and thyroid. Patients that are active, that do day-to-day activities that cause their hands to swell.
And what are the symptoms of carpal tunnel syndrome?
So most of the patients that come to our office present with numbness and tingling in the thumb, index, and middle finger. Sometimes it's pain. Sometimes it's waking up at night with their hands numb and asleep. But day-to-day activities, driving your car can cause numbness and tingling in those fingers with carpal tunnel syndrome. When carpal tunnel syndrome gets worse, it has a tendency to cause you to get weak in your hands. And when that happens, you drop things, you drop cups, you drop bigger objects that you're trying to pick up. But the majority of the patients come in with numbness and tingling and night symptoms.
And how do you treat carpal tunnel syndrome?
So we always try to treat conservatively. So we send them to therapy. You have them take anti-inflammatories. They can use night splints to sleep at night, and then that can really help with the numbness and tingling symptoms at nighttime. Therapy can help to an extent. Sometimes we'll even do a cortisone injection to reduce the swelling around those tendons and help to kind of take the pressure off the nerve. And then if all that fails and the symptoms progress, then there is a carpal tunnel surgery that we can do to fix it. And it's a very effective way of getting rid of carpal tunnel syndrome.
So what does the surgery entail and how quick is the recovery?
So surgery involves basically taking the pressure off the nerve or opening the space for the carpal tunnel. And if you look at this model here, the carpal tunnel is the space underneath this big ligament. And if you open that space up, you can see the nerve and the tendons are underneath it. So nowadays, the surgery involves making a cut through this big, thick ligament. And once you make that cut, the ligament is open and it takes the pressure off the nerve. And it's very effective. Recovery from carpal tunnel surgery nowadays is anywhere from 2 to 3 weeks. You can get back to doing most activities. The hand stays a little weak and in strength for up to a month, but the symptoms go away within the first week of surgery most of the time.
So how do you reduce your risk of getting carpal tunnel syndrome in the first place?
So that's a great question. You know, I think the biggest reduction is avoid repetitive activities, especially strenuous repetitive activities. We have patients that come in and have spent, you know, 8 hours in the garden cutting and shearing things. And that's really hard on your hands. If you take frequent breaks, you know, every hour, you do some stretching exercises where you can kind of stretch the fingers, redistribute the swelling around the tendons to not focus on the carpal tunnel area. Then that obviously helps. Do things in moderation. Wear protective braces if you are susceptible to carpal tunnel syndrome. That can help also. But the less you do repetitive for a prolonged period of times, the less likely you are to develop it.
And what about wrist exercises?
So there are some wrist exercises that the therapists find useful, and there's some that have been presented to be beneficial. Primarily, the therapists will teach you how to do stretching exercises of the flexor tendons. So you try to stretch your fingers out straight, bend them down, wrist flexion, wrist extension. There's also a stretching exercise with the rubber band that the therapists like to use where you put a rubber band around the tip of the fingers and you kind of work at stretching them out and bending them down. And somehow this kind of takes a little bit of the pressure off the nerve, and it helps to get the tendons to move a little easier in the carpal tunnel. The stretching exercises can be helpful even if you have pain, especially if you're waking up at night. Some patients will run their hand under hot water and do those stretching exercises. The rubber band exercise is more of a preventative thing, but the finger stretching exercises can help even if you wake up with symptoms in the middle of the night.
If your wrist has been bothering you, at what point should you say, I need to go see a doctor, get diagnosed and treated for this?
As soon as it starts waking you up at night, really is the primary reason to come in.
Any final thoughts, doctor?
So yes, carpal tunnel syndrome is a very common problem we see in our hand clinics. And it really comes down to being a problem with overuse of your hands on a day-to-day basis, doing too many things. And it's important to understand that, you know, when you do develop symptoms, your fingers are going numb and tingly, waking you up at night, keeping you from doing things, to come in and get evaluated. Because sometimes if you ignore them for a prolonged period of time, they can cause permanent damage to the nerve and the use of your hands. So it's not something you want to ignore.
Thanks so much, doctor. We appreciate you taking the time to be with us.
Thank you, Susan.
If you want more information on carpal tunnel syndrome, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.